our first lesson, we're talking about internal linking, because internal linking is one of the most complex things to get right in SEO. Larger sites with a lot of content and many different URLs are especially complex to master. So let's go through a couple of things that you have to consider when internal linking sites with each other. Generally, with internal links, we want to link one page to another to help Google to discover content while also creating a hierarchy to reflect which pages are more important than others. Internal linking fulfills different tasks. It ensures accessibility of documents. It also prioritizes content and distributes what we call link juice, and more on that in just a few seconds. Further, it also helps to cluster content and create context and explain what a page is supposed to rank for. The most common link types are either text links or image links. Their value varies depending on where they are located. So there are navigational links, there are content links where most of the context is around, we have links in the sidebar, and we have links in the footer. A link generally have two different elements that we really need to be aware of. Eventually, sometimes there are even three. So one is obviously the destination, which is the href attribute. And then also another one is the anchor text, which is describing the contents of the destination where the link is pointing to. And thirdly, we have something that's called the nofollow attribute. Another important aspect is what SEOs often refer to as link juice. The main idea is that link juice is kind of a definer for all the negative and positive characteristics that can be passed by an internal link or an external link from one URL to the other. So the key thing about internal linking is accessibility. Optimized website architecture really helps to ensure that accessibility for crawlers and users is given at the same time. Ideally, all content should be accessible within a maximum of 3 to 4 clicks away from the homepage. So Google doesn't have to go from one page to another just to find the content. As a rule, the closer the URL is connected to the homepage, the more important it should be in your internal hierarchy. Or the other way around. You know, if it takes, for example, 10 clicks to reach a certain content, it can't be really that important, can it? So one of the main things that significantly can help with internal linking, and particularly proper anchor texts, are breadcrumbs. So breadcrumbs essentially reflect the navigational path from where you are in within a domain. You should use respective markup to ensure Google can pick up on that and display your breadcrumbs properly. I recommend visiting schema.org if you're not familiar with the implementation of breadcrumbs. You can check all the properties and examples on how to implement them in a very correct way. Another important aspect is crawler management, in particular your robots text file. Make sure that your important pages are supposed to pass link juice from one to the other, that they are not blocked in the robots text. Those critical links must be readable during a classic web crawl, which means you should rely on using simple Ahrefs instead of JavaScript. Please refer to chapter 8 in this course. We're covering JavaScript in way more detail. One of the easiest internal linking tips is to find orphan pages. These are essentially pages that are not internally linked anymore. However, they were at some point and they're getting traffic because of other factors. So if you find those orphan pages, you could use Google Search Console or Google Analytics as a starting point, for example. And then basically implement and link them again from your other pages. To get a deeper view on how your website is performing in terms of internal linking, we suggest you use the internal linking report within SEMrush Site Audit tool. It allows you to analyze internal link distribution across your website's pages. It lets you see internal linking issues, such as broken links or excessive on-page links. And it also suggests, you know, which pages to link with one and each other to just make internal linking better, and then gives you recommendations from which URL you're actually supposed to link to the other one.